Hi, welcome to this quick tutorial on sales tax calculations. We're going to work forward to calculate sales tax to determine a final price, as well as working backwards to calculate the sales tax from a final price. So this is what we're going to cover. Firstly, we're going to talk about calculating sales tax from a final price. So in that way, we're going to work backwards. And we're also going to calculate the final price that includes the sales tax in a way which is working forwards. I'm going to run through examples with both. With Formula 2 there, calculating the final price, including sales tax, there are also other uses for that particular formula, which we're going to discuss briefly. Okay, first up, calculating sales tax from a final price. So if you're given a final selling price, or if you purchase a product that includes sales tax, it's pretty straightforward to calculate the included sales tax. The formula is given there on the screen. It's simply price minus price divided by 1 plus the sales tax rate. So just jot that down or pause or whatever. But here's an example anyway. So we have a good that sold for $39. And we know that the sales tax rate is 12.5%. So we simply plug in those numbers into the formula. So price minus price divided by 1 plus the sales tax. Or $39 minus 39 divided by... So you got to know your arithmetic operators to work out the brackets first. So 1 plus 0.125 is 1.125. 39 divided by 1.125, and you take away that from 39. And that, the sales tax, if you can keep up with my jumbled explanation, the sales tax is $4.33. So try that on your calculator and you'll see you'll have the same situation. All right, calculate the final price, including the sales tax. So if you know the pre-tax cost of a product, it's straightforward to calculate the final selling price that includes the sales tax. And the formula is simply cost times 1 plus the sales tax rate. So cost is the pre-tax cost of the product times 1 plus the sales tax rate. Okay, so here's our example. We have a product that costs $55, perhaps in our shop that we're going to sell. We know we have to add 15% sales tax onto it. So we simply plug in the numbers, 55 times 1 plus 0.15. So don't forget percentages, got to put them in decimal figures, so it's 0.15. So 55 times 1 plus 0.15. And if you plug that into a calculator, you did find out that the final selling price is $63.25. And then using that figure, you can also calculate the actual sales tax amount, which is just final selling price minus cost, which is $63.25 minus $55. So your sales tax will be $8.25. Okay, there are other uses for that final price calculation formula. So the formula cost times 1 plus the sales tax rate is also the markup pricing formula. So you might see that formula expressed this way. You might see it as cost times 1 plus the markup percentage. And you'll realize that many businesses, maybe your own or one that you're studying, work with fixed or desired markups in setting prices. So they may have purchased inventory for $120 or manufactured inventory for $120 and they want to sell it with a 30% markup. Perhaps all of this type of products get sold at a 30% markup. So you can simply use that formula and replace the sales tax rate with the markup percentage and calculate your final selling price. And in this case, it would be $120, which is the cost of the purchased inventory, times 1 plus 0.3, 30% markup. And the final selling price would be $156. And then from there, you can also work out the markup, which was 156 minus 120, which is 36 is the markup. This is what we covered today. We calculated sales tax from a final price. Secondly, we calculated a final price that includes sales tax based on a product cost. And then finally, we talked about other uses for the final price calculation formula, such as the markup percentage. If you have any feedback or you need further assistance, please get in contact. Otherwise, good luck and best wishes and thanks for your time today.